Good morning to one and all. So in our yesterday class, we have been discussed the automobile laws and vehicle act, all these things. So due to uncertainty in our classes, we will continue the topic. So let us move into our topic. So we are having so many pollution, air pollution, water pollution, and so many pollutants also, and where it is coming from, and that means the emissions, where the emissions and where the pollutants, and which gas we are burning, and what are the chemicals we are emissions we are getting into our atmosphere. All these things we have to discuss in our right class right now. So before knowing the pollution and pollutants, we have to know about the automobile law. That means vehicle, motor vehicles act. So the act, the motor vehicle act, the motor vehicle act is coming into action from 1988 in two schedules, that is 217 sections, right? So there have been three subsequent amendments also. Just waiting. Right. So due to subsequent amendments, that is 94, 2000, and 2001. So the first schedule gives various traffic signs, while in second schedule it is given in compensation of a third party accident or injury cases claim. So the topic may be dividing into so many types. So coming to the driving license, coming to the registration, first of all, you people also have to know the registration also. No vehicle can be driven unless it is registered and the registration mark is displayed. Is displayed in the a very particular manner. So the vehicle may be got registered by the registering authority in the state in which the owner has the residence or business where the vehicle is normally kept. So for this purpose, the owner has to apply in the prescribed form. Is my voice is audible? If there is any problem, please inform to me, right? Right. So registration may be compulsory. So the registration certificate issued in any state is valid throughout the India. So this thing already knows all these people who are listening our class. So the registration certificate may be issued in a valid period of time of 15 years and can be subsequently renewed for a period of 5 years. So this is the thing happening in our registration. So when a motor vehicle registered in one state, it may be kept to another state for a period of exceeding 12 months. Therefore, then we have to take a new registration mark and may be obtained from the registering authority of that state. So this is the thing we have to observe in our registrations for two-wheelers or four-wheelers, whatever we are using. So coming to the driving license, so person who can driving a motorcycle in any public places must have the holds the valid driving license. That means here we are having two types. One is learner license and another one is permanent license. So learner license is effective for a period of only 6 months. It is already known. And the permanent, that means the driving license issued or renewed in case of transport vehicle, and may be valid for 3 years. So if the person having the license is not 40 years and the date of issue, it may be renewal is effective for a period of 20 years or until the person attains the age of 40 years, whichever it is earlier. So this is the thing in our driving license importance. And coming to the traffic signals, we are having so many things. And before knowing the traffic signals, all these things, we have to know the vehicle safety standards and regulations. Why? Because before why we have to know the standards and regulations, because the effective emissions which are pollutes the atmosphere, those may be regulated using the standards and regulations, right? So that's why we have to know the vehicle safety standards and also the regulations, both the things we have to identify. So here this may be the rule may be coming into the rule may be passed in, that means the Motor Vehicles Act may be passed in 1988, but it may be coming into enforcement for Central Motor Vehicle Rules in 1989. So in order to a systematic condition, we are having so many things already. We know all these things, even though I want to say these things that are brake performance for four-wheelers and anti-theft devices for two-wheelers and four-wheelers and field of vision of motor vehicle drivers and the strength of superstructure and vehicle alarm system, child restraint system, vehicle identification number, bumpers of the vehicles, MI vehicles. And next is the prevention of fire risk, rear end and front end collision, protection of occupant in the event of a frontal and lateral collision. So these are all the regulations which are coming into enforcement from 1988 or 1989 to up to 2007. Right. So these are all the acts. So these are all the acts of standards we have to maintain. From from 1989 to up to right now also, right? So these are all the things implemented up to 2007. So coming to the emission, so the norms of cars and commercial vehicles have already been enforced in the entire country, whereas we have a mandatory for cars and commercial vehicles. That means in Delhi, Mumbai, Kolkata, Bangalore, Hyderabad. So that means we are having certain according to our area. So it is proposed to enforce the Bharat Stage 3. That means Euro 3. We are calling it as Euro 3 norms for cars and commercial vehicles with Stage 4 norms also. In metro cities with an effect from 2010. So for any two-wheelers and three-wheelers, it may be enforced from 2005 to 2010. So it may be emissions may be tightened. The emissions may be tightened. That means here, what is emissions? What are the different types of emissions we are getting? What is the pollution? What are the different types of pollutants we are facing in nowadays? So coming to the on screen, we are shared emissions, air pollution and criteria polluted. So emission, what is the emission? It's a collective term that is used to describe the undesired gases and particles which are released into the air or emitted by various sources. So this is the main thing we have to observe. So this is the definition of the emission. So coming to the air pollution, it is defined as the addition of any material which have a dangerous effect for plant to our atmosphere. So emissions is a collective term that is used to describe the undesirable gases and particles so which are released into the air or emitted by the various sources. So this is the main definition for emissions and air pollution. So right. So coming to the, what are the pollutants in US, the US Environmental Protection Agency, EPA, Environmental Protection Agency, primarily concerned with emissions that are harmful to the public. So EPA, that means Environmental Protection Agency, considers carbon monoxide, CO, carbon monoxide, and lead, PB, we will call it as PB, right? So nitrogen oxide. So nitrogen dioxide means NO2. This is the chemical name of that particular chemical pollutant. we are facing in our regular life. So this is ozone, O3, and particulate matter. Particulate matter means we will call it as PM. So this is the particulate matter. Next, sulfur dioxide. Sulfur dioxide is SO2. This is the chemical sulfur dioxide. This is, we will call it as SO2. So this is one of the, these are all the primary pollutants. These are all the primary pollutants. Carbon monoxide, CO. One more time I am repeating. Why? Because these are all the primary pollutants. What are the primary pollutants? Carbon monoxide and lead, nitrogen dioxide, ozone, particulate matter, and sulfur dioxide. So CO, PB, NO2, O3, PM, and SO2. So these are all the primary pollutants. So coming to this, we are having different sources of pollutants may be released from different sources. We are getting different pollutants. So here you can observe, one is point sources, second one is mobile sources, and third one is the biogenic sources. So what is meant by point sources? Point sources means here, so which include facilities such as factories and electric power plants, right? So these are all the points. That means these are all the stationary. Factory and electric power plants are the stationary points. Those may be released with the total pollutant into the atmosphere. So this one we are calling them as point sources. So coming to the second one, mobile sources, which includes cars, trucks. So those are all moving, kinetic energy. Those are all moving. Therefore, we are also having lawn mowers, airplanes, and anything else that moves and releases pollutants into the air directly. It may be spreading throughout, where it up to starting point, ending point, that is moving one. So this is the second one. So that is the mobile sources. Coming to the third one, biogenic sources. So biogenic sources, which includes trees and vegetation, gas seeps, and microbial activity. So these are all the biogenic sources. And coming to the fourth one, area sources. This is the stationary sources, such as the dry cleaners, very small things, dry cleaners, degreasing operations. So these are all the types of pollutants we are facing. Right. Just wait a second. Right. So total four different types of sources: point sources, mobile sources, biogenic sources, area sources. So totally four different types of pollution sources we are having in our regular life. So coming to this is the pollution gases, which may be divided into two types. One is primary, and second one is criteria pollution. What is the primary pollutants? Already we have discussed in our starting point. So that is carbon monoxide, CO2, and lead, PB, and nitrogen dioxide, NO2, ozone, O3, particulate matter, PM, sulfur dioxide, SO2. So I am saying that those chemical names and name, both, I am saying to you people right now. So here on screen, we are sharing carbon monoxide, CO2, primary pollutant, methane, CH4, and nitrous oxide, that is NO2. Nitrogen dioxide is also comes under this one. So right, coming to the second point, this is the criteria pollutant. So first one is primary, and second one is criteria. So that is the secondary pollutant, like carbon monoxide. So it is also called as CO. So total nitrogen oxide. So the point which is coming from nitrogen, then it may be one of the pollutants, so NOx. Next, sulfur dioxide and non-methane. So non-methane volatile organic compounds, NMVOC, and particulate matter, lead. So these are all comes under to criteria pollutants. So primary pollutants are carbon monoxide, methane, nitrous oxide, NO. So these three comes under primary. Criteria pollutants may be, so starting we are discussed so many types of pollutants. So this may be divided into two types. One is primary and second one is criteria. So criteria pollutants means carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, sulfur dioxide and particulate matter and lead. So these are all the pollutants. We may be divided into two types. So right. Okay, we know the emission definition, we know the pollution definition, we know the pollutants, we know the division and why they are divided, how we are divided, right? So coming to point, where it was released, from where it was coming, so that means the pollution, where it is coming. So burning, so fuel is burned in the IC engine, internal combustion engine. The fuel is burned in the internal combustion engine. The air or gasoline residuals are emitted through the tailpipe, through the tailpipe. So next thing is, heat causes fuel to evaporate throughout the fuel system, and hot sunny days and engines warmed by running provide heat to vaporize fuel into the air. So this is the second point we have to identify and observe. And the third one is refueling. That means where the pollutants are pollutes the atmosphere, the point where it is coming from, right? Refueling at the service station where gasoline vapors escape into the air, right? So these are the three points. And coming to this, this is the same kind of operation. Air pollution gases. So one is for same kind, not at all same kind, some kind. So already we have been discussed, already we know the thing, we know the different pollutants: CO, CO2, NOx, HC, PM, lead, nitrogen oxide and particulate matter, SO2. All these are all concerned into the air pollution gases, right? So what are the effect? What are the effect of pollution? The pollution in vehicle emissions may be known as to damage the lung tissue. So lung tissues may be damaged due to these pollutants, right? So that means we will feel some certain irritation on our throat. Therefore, it may be entered into our lungs. It may be damage our lungs. Next thing is motor vehicle pollution also contributes to the formation of acid rain and add to the greenhouse gases that cause climate change, right? Next thing is on warm or sunny days, hydrocarbons react with oxides. Hydrocarbon reacts with oxides of nitrogen to create a secondary pollutant ozone, So in many urban areas, motor vehicles are the single largest contributor to ground level ozone, which is a common component of smog. So ozone causes coughing, wheezing and shortness of breath. So this is the present thing happening in our total universe. So total people are facing certain problems due to certain different pollutants which may be released from where it is coming. We didn't know about all these things, but anyways, due to pollution we are facing certain harmful problems. So carbon monoxide reduces the flow of oxygen into the blood. So carbon monoxide, so this is one of the pollutants, we have to know this one, which will reduces the oxygen in the bloodstream, reduce the oxygen in the flow of oxygen into the bloodstream, and is particularly dangerous to the person with heart disease. So this is the point you have to note down for this present situation, right? Coming to this, this is the solution. So that means all these pollutants will create certain harmful to the either human being or either vehicles or either atmosphere. So what are the solutions? What are the how to reduce these things? So honestly, we have been sharing engine design modification. That is the first one. Second one is cleaner fuel. Cleaner fuel means CNG, compressed natural gas. And third one is post-combustion control device. And fourth one is inspection and maintenance devices. And fifth one is zero emission vehicles. Already we have been discussed the zero emission vehicles include battery electric vehicles, plug-in hybrid electric vehicles, and hydrogen fuel cell electric vehicles. So these are all the different types of zero emission vehicles. Those are all battery electric vehicles, right? Next thing is reduce the pollution from our vehicles by driving less, improving our driving habits. Reduce the pollution from our vehicles by driving less. That means the moving capacity may be reduced, and the improving our driving habits. We have to change your habits also and keep our vehicles in good running order. If we are not having in proper running, we will face certain pollutants into our atmosphere. So make sure tires are properly inflated. Make sure the gasoline cap fits properly, and drive at a steady, moderate speeds. And increase the green land. That means whenever we are driving less, then it may be increases the green land. So how to measure the technique? What are the measuring techniques? That means measurement techniques used to measure the pollutant. Pollutant pollution checkup panni manaki maamuluga kanipistha untaru kada. So akkadiki yellinappudu then we will go for pollution checkup. We will get the pollutants also. So, but as per our climate, it's we know the basic knowledge, but we are having so many methods that we measure the pollutant. These measuring equipment may be available in the industries only. So first thing is non-dispersive infrared analyzer, that is NDIR. These are the detectors in the industry. Standard method. These are the detectors which have been used in the industries for the standard method of measuring. That means very new vehicles, those people are measured the standard, and then only it may be coming on to the road. So measuring and concentration of carbon dioxide, so CO and CO2. And second point is absorption bands, common gases. So the flame ions, so absorption bands, common gases. So absorption may be absorption of gases may be obtained by using this flame ionization detector, FID. This is also one of the industrial standard techniques for measuring hydrocarbon HC and HC concentration. Right. Next, coming to the chemiluminescence detector, CLD. It is also one of the industrial standard methods for measuring nitric oxide concentration. So we are having totally three types. Non-dispersive infrared analyzer, and second one is flame ionization detector, and third one is chemiluminescence detector. So using these three detectors, we can observe carbon dioxide concentration, hydrocarbon concentration, and nitric oxide concentration. So three types of pollutants may be measured using these three types of instruments. So how to control the emission? So these are all the pollution measurements. So right now, coming to the control of emission in an IC engine. So to reduce atmospheric pollution, we are following two types of approaches. One is to reduce the formation of pollutants in the emission by redesigning the engine system. So that means here you can observe these are the points. So engine design modification, solution and control of emission, both are maybe regular same. So right, next fuel system, cooling system, and ignition system. And the second point is, so these are all we have to redesign it. Coming to the second point, by destroying the pollutants after these have been formed, right? So pollutant formation, so pollutant formation means here hydrocarbons HC, nitrogen oxides NOx, and carbon monoxide CO, carbon dioxide CO2, evaporative emissions HC, and not tailpipe emissions. So these are all the different types of pollutants we are facing from the starting onwards. So how the pollutant may be formed, how the hydrocarbon HC may be formed, this is the first point. So this emission results fuel molecules in the engine and do not burn or burn only partially. So this is the hydrocarbons which may be obtained by our silencer. So either burning by either combustion or by non-combustion, both either burning or non-burning. It may be partially coming from the tailpipe. Therefore, next thing is nitrogen oxides and NOx. So under the high pressure and temperature conditions in an engine, nitrogen and oxygen atoms in the air react to form various nitrogen oxides, collectively known as NOx. And next thing is carbon monoxide, CO. So it is a product of incomplete combustion and occurs when carbon in the fuel, and it is partially oxidized rather than fully oxidized to carbon dioxide. So these are the three pollutants formation. And coming to the carbon dioxide, it does not directly impair human health. It's a greenhouse gas, so it traps the earth heat and contributes to the potential for global warming. And next thing is evaporative emissions. So hydrocarbon pollutants also escape into the air through fuel evaporation, and evaporative losses can account for a majority of the total hydrocarbon pollution. So these are the pollution formation. So these are the evaporative emissions occur several ways. One is journal, next one is running losses, and next third one is hot soak and refueling. So these are the SI engine emissions. SI engine emissions is divided into three types. One is exhaust emission, two is evaporative emission, three is crankcase emission. So the major pollutants are CO, carbon monoxide, nitrogen oxide, and hydrogen carbon. So SI engine emissions may be coming in these four ways. So one is evaporative. So here you can observe evaporative, that means carburetor. Next one is fuel tank, and next one is crankcase. So these are all the emissions we are getting. So we are having three places. SI engine emissions. SI means, so here you can observe SI engine emissions are divided into three types. So in these three ways, we are getting the emissions: hydrocarbon, carbon monoxide, and nitrogen oxide. So coming to the SI emissions, these are the SI emissions. So CI engine emissions, so we are having total six types. So here you can observe, depends, not at all six types, it depends. So the prevailing conditions, not only during combustion, but also during the expansion, and especially prior to the exhaust valve opening. And second thing is mixture preparation during the ignition delay. And the third one is fuel ignition quality. And fourth one is residence time at different combustion temperatures. And fifth one is evaporation, expansion duration. And sixth one is general engine design features. So these are all the causes. These are all the formed at a result of burning of air fuel mixture. So this is. So this is the CI engine emission. So incomplete combustion and mixing of unburned hydrocarbons and NO is formed, is not decomposed. So these are all the different causes. These are all the different causes. So this is the how to control the emission from SI engines. So this is the one of the thing we are getting. So evaporative emission control. So EMBEEC. So that means C. So how to control the emission of the SI engine, how to control in the CI engine. These are the total control of emission from SI engine. This is the line diagram you have to observe here. Here you can observe from the starting end. Air filter, throttle. So here you can observe the fuel tank. From the fuel tank, the vapor liquid separated and filter tube. So here you can observe the cleaner pipe, sealed filter cap. So the total air may be, total air fuel mixture may be filtered using this controller, right? Sealed fuel tank is kept under vacuum to prevent permeation of fuel through walls of a polymer fuel टैंक एंड लीकेज ऑफ फ्यूल वेपर्स थ्रू फिलर कैप. तो फ्यूल ट्यूबिंग मेड ऑफ हाई डेंसिटी पॉलीमर और स्टील टू रिड्यूस प्रिवेंट फ्यूल परमिएशन. सो दिस इज द कंट्रोल ऑफ एमिशन फ्रॉम एसआई इंजन. सो दिस इज अनदर मेथड कंट्रोल ऑफ एमिशन फ्रॉम एसआई. सो दिस इज ईजीआर. ईजीआर EGR control valve is used to regulate the flow of flow of EGR depending upon the engine operating conditions. So here you can observe the total diagram. Vacuum operated EGR control valve. So this is the water injection. It is not generally used. It may be affect the total engine system. So that means the corrosion problem is also attained using this engine water injection. So it is not correct for the present situation. So control of emission of diesel engine. So this is the diesel engine technology, emission control technologies. One is PM control and oxidation or lean NOx catalyst reduce the diesel emissions and PM, and diesel particulate filter system reduce the, it will reduce the PM and diesel emissions. So special ceramic coatings applied to the combustion zones, surfaces of the piston crown, valves and head, and reduces the PM and NOx. So this is the ceramic coatings. Ceramic coatings plus oxidation catalyst. Ceramic coatings allows the engine to reduce NOx, where CO and particulates are maintained at low levels. So the coating may be inner one. So gaseous emissions. These are all the control technologies, right? So this is the gaseous emission. So these are all the gaseous, right? So no need to know the gaseous one. We have to know the up to diesel engine and SI engine. So what are the control in, what are the pollutants, what are the division, where it is coming from, what are the solutions, and what are the controlling systems, and what are the gases we are raising, how many classifications of pollution, all these things may be known up to right now. So the control of emission from the diesel and petrol engine are also we are getting, that is SI and PA engines also we are know the controlling of emissions, right? So up to right now the emission of pollutants may be, the topic may be concluded. So thank you.